Firebase is a Google service that helps developers create mobile and web applications. It includes services like a database, application hosting, machine learning, etc. In this section of the series, we'll only cover the Firestore database. Firestore is a NoSQL database for mobile and web apps. It's easy to work with, can scale to global size, allows us to structure our data in any way we want, and easily authenticate users. If you want to follow along with the examples in this lesson, you'll need a basic Vue app, as well as a Google account. To help us more easily interact with a Firestore database, we can install the Firebase SDK. It's available as an NPM package, so we can install it with npm install Firebase. Once the installation is finished, we'll see it under dependencies in the package.json file. To create a new database, head over to firebase.google.com and click on the console button in the top right corner. From there, create a project. Give it a name and click Continue. We don't need analytics for a learning project, so we'll toggle it off and click Create. From the project dashboard, go to the Build menu, select Firestore Database, and choose Create Database. In the pop-up screen, choose Start in Test Mode and click Next. We'll cover how to secure the application later on. For the location, we can leave the default one that Firebase chooses for us and click Enable. Once the database has been created, we can go back to the project's dashboard. The next step is to connect our app to the database, so we'll click on the angle brackets for web apps. Then, give the app a nickname and click Register App. Because we've already installed the SDK, we can just copy this code snippet. It initializes the connected app with your personalized config object. If you need to find the code snippet again, click on the gear icon, choose Project Settings, then scroll down. At this point, the database is set up, so the next step is to configure and initialize it. In the project source directory, create a new file with firebase/init.js. Then, paste in the code snippet you copied earlier. The final step is to initialize the Firestore service. To do that, we need to import the getFirestore method from firebase/firestore and initialize it at the bottom. We'll also export it so that we can use it in our components around the application. All right. Now we're set up and ready to start working with Firebase. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next one.